Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Amma ba'd. Ramadan Mubarak to everyone at the MCC community. While it's certainly a unique set of events that we are unable to see each other and meet each other and greet each other at the masjid, and we miss those opportune moments, we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of His blessings. Subhanallah, there's just, the reality is that there's just so much to be thankful for despite all that is not working out for us right now. Unfortunately, we're not able to go to the masjid, and we are hoping and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow for this to be something that energizes us in the near future when we start going to the masjid and we start becoming more diligent when we go to the masjid, inshallah, by the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with that said, once again, Ramadan Mubarak. I pray to Allah that this Ramadan is one full of blessings for us and our families and our communities, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us for all of our good actions, but may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also reward us for the struggles that we're going through in this month of Ramadan, because we're not able to do so many of the things that we do communally at the masjid. Insha'Allah, Allah is Kareem, Allah is kind, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward every single one of us, insha'Allah. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. It will be my pleasure, insha'Allah, to be with you once a week, whether it be virtually in this format, and be able to share a few things with you during the course of the month of Ramadan. It's a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, you know, while we are unable to see each other, we're able to access many of our teachers. I get to hear so many of my local teachers and colleagues as well online, and that's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate all of our teachers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve them and their families, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them for all the sacrifices that they make. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. What I want to do, there's a text called the Ramadan of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the Prophet's Ramadan sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's some portions in there that I want to spend the next few moments sharing with you, inshallah. When the month of Ramadan would begin, there's a hadith Ubadah ibn Samit radiyallahu anhu narrates from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that when Ramadan would begin, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make a dua, Allahumma sallimni li Ramadan wa sallim Ramadan li wa sallimhu li mutaqabbala. O Allah, preserve me for Ramadan, preserve Ramadan for me, and accept my deeds, or preserve my deeds in the course of this month. That's why there's a narration, Aisha radiallahu anha narrates, that when the month of Ramadan would come, the color of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would change. Imam Munadi, in explaining why the color would change, he said that it would change because out of a fear of a weakness occurring that could result him in not fulfilling the requirements of worship. In other words, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would get worried. You know, while of course naturally he was happy as we all are, but there would be a certain fear, a certain worry on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that fear and that worry was that, you know, that his condition would change and that he would not be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this month is a month dedicated to direct acts of worship, of ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Starting from our fard prayers, starting from our fard fasting to our sunnah prayers, be those the prayers that we associate with all of our five prayers, or be it Salatul Taraweeh, the recitation of the Quran, giving in charity, all of these things completely dedicated to Ramadan, right? That's why the time in Ramadan is not to be wasted, right? The time in Ramadan is not to be wasted. All these other things that, you know, we do otherwise can actually wait until after Ramadan. That's how the Sahaba used to prepare for the month of Ramadan. Now, of course, we're still in slightly in the beginning of Ramadan. By the time you will see this recording, it will be, the fourth day of Ramadan and potentially the fifth night or the sixth, but khair. What the point is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to congratulate the Sahaba. The Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam would congratulate his companions by saying, and these are the words of the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "The month of Ramadan has come to you. It's a blessed month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed its fast upon you. In it, the gates of paradise are opened, the doors of hell are closed, and the devils are locked up. In it is a night that's better than 1,000 months, and whoever is deprived of its goodness is surely one who is deprived." Not only, you know, there's that hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where once the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was climbing a pulpit, he was climbing a minbar, and as he climbed the first step, he said Ameen. As he climbed the second step, he said Ameen. As he climbed the third step, he said Ameen. The Sahaba later inquired, first of all, the Sahaba, you know, looked and said, "What's happening?" Then they inquired, and the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam responded and said that Jibra'il Ameen alayhi salatu wasalam came to me, and he made three supplications, and I said Ameen to all three. They said, "Ya Rasulullah, what are those three supplications?" The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam responded and said that be deprived or be destroyed the individual who upon whom it comes the month of Ramadan and he does not acquire his forgiveness during the course of this month. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "That is a dua that Jibra'il Ameen made," and I said Ameen to it. The second dua he made was that be deprived or be destroyed that individual who finds his parents alive and doesn't serve them enough to guarantee entry into paradise. The Nabi alayhi salam says, I said Ameen to it. And the third time I said Ameen was the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that Jibra'il Ameen said that you be deprived or be destroyed the individual upon whom your name, the name of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam is mentioned, and they don't send salutations upon you. And the Nabi alayhi salam says, I said Ameen to it. In other words, Allah has made forgiveness so easy during this month of Ramadan. As one of our teachers and friends recently shared an example with us, and he said it's like a person, it's raining outside and it's about getting wet. How easy it is. All you have to do if it's raining is step outside and come right back in, and before you know it, you'll be wet. You'll be wet even if you don't want to get wet. Right? Many a times it's raining and you have to step outside to grab your mail from the mailbox or go to your car for something, and you don't want to get wet, but you still end up getting wet. That's what Ramadan is like. Right? That's what the blessings of the month of Ramadan are like. That even if you don't want, if just a little, all you have to do is open that door and step outside. Right? All you have to do is open that door and step outside, and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will attach itself to you. Right? The forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will attach itself to you. So we learn that when the month of Ramadan would begin, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam would congratulate his companions. So we can say Ramadan Mubarak to each other, and we can continue saying Marhaba, Marhaba Ya Ramadan, right? Marhaba, we welcome you, we welcome you, O month of Ramadan. We should be in gratitude that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed us to enter into the month of Ramadan. We have witnessed the month of Ramadan, and hopefully by now, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven our sins, and from here onwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate our status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Greeting the month of Ramadan, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is narrated to have said, "O people, Ramadan, the chief, the Sayyidah of all of the months has come to you, so we welcome and we greet this month." What I want to share in the few moments that I have left is a sermon. This is a very famous sermon. Salman al-Farisi radiallahu anhu narrates that on the last day of Sha'ban, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam delivered a khutbah, delivered a sermon, and it is as follows. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "O people, a very blessed month is about to come over you." This is the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam teaching his companions the merits of this month, the importance of this month, the grandeur, the greatness of this month. And we take this hadith as a reminder for us to increase in our actions and make our actions better. "O people, A very blessed month is about to come over you. A month in which is a night better than 1,000 months. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, the hadith, you know, a lot of times the Quranic ayah says, خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ, and we say, oh, better than 84 years of worship. This is just to show, a lot of times in the hadith, we have examples of 3, 7, you know, 100, 700. Allah is using the term 1,000 here. In other words, it is so, so large. Better than 1,000 months could mean better than 1,000 years or better than 1,000 lifetimes. We don't know the magnitude of this. Just don't lose out on it is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us, and the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam reminds us. He continues, a month whose fasts Allah has prescribed for you and made its qiyam, its prayers, a source of reward. Whoever gets close to Allah in it with voluntary good deeds will be like the one undertaking fard in the other months. Any voluntary deed, brothers and sisters. You know, the sunnah prayers that we do and the nafl prayers that we do and any voluntary action that we do, we will get the reward of an obligatory action. And then he continues and says, whoever fulfills a fard in it will be like the one fulfilling 70 fara'id in another month. So for every fajr prayer that we do, we get the reward of 70 fajrs. Every dhuhr prayer that we do, we get the reward of 70 dhuhr prayers. Now that doesn't mean that it's equivalent to 70 dhuhrs and that we don't have to make up dhuhrs that we've made that we've missed in the past. It just means that Allah will give us the reward of that prayer times 70. It's a month of patience. And the reward of patience is paradise. It's a month of empathy and a month in which the believer's livelihood, rizq, is increased. Brothers and sisters, I know many of us are going through financial difficulties. And I know that many of us are worried what the next few weeks and the next few months will bring. But let us not forget the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we want to guarantee financial goodness in the upcoming days and months, then be as charitable as you can in this month, and Allah will reward us and Allah will return it back to us. Whoever provides food to open the fast of another will have the forgiveness of his sins and freedom from hell. He will receive the same reward as the fasting person, and there will be no reduction in the reward of the fasting person. On this, some of the companions pointed out and said, Oh Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, not all of us have the means to feed a fasting individual. And the Prophet responded and said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that Allah will give such a reward to one who gives even one date or one drop of milk or water. In other words, you don't have to give much to the fasting individual. Have the honor, figure out, find ways where we can bring the date or the water or the milk or the food to the dinner table of the fasting individual to attain that reward. It is, and by the way, this doesn't mean that it has to be someone else. This reward could be for your own families. If you have done the grocery shopping through which people will eat that evening, if you've done the cooking through which people, your own family will eat that evening, that reward will be with you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? A lot of times we think even in our homes, you've done the groceries, you've done the shopping, you've paid for it, you've cooked for it, you've worked hard for that meal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reward you. It's a month. أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةً. The first part is mercy. We're going through the first 10 days of mercy. وَأَوْسَطُهُ مَغْفِرَةً. The middle 10 days are of forgiveness. And وَآخِرُهُ. The last 10 days are عِتْقٌ مِّنَ النَّارِ. Are freedom from the fire of hell. Make plentiful 4 things in it. With 2 of them you can please your Lord, and without the other 2 you cannot survive. The 2 things with which you can please your Lord are the dhikr of the kalima tayyiba, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, and istighfar, seeking forgiveness. The best way to do this, brothers and sisters, is after every prayer, say la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah 3 times, and astaghfirullah, or astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbin wa atubu ilayh, or any form of istighfar, after every prayer, 3 times. And if you are inclined that before Salatul Maghrib, or before Salatul Fajr, as you're waiting for the prayer, or after Salatul Fajr, you're trying to find an easy form of dhikr, that you don't have to work too hard, find a tasbih, and say la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah 100 times, and astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah 100 times. And the 2 things which with which you cannot survive are asking Allah for paradise and seeking His protection from the hellfire. Right? Oh Allah, give me paradise, give me protection from the hellfire. Right? Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika min an-nar. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-jannah wa na'udhu bika min an-nar. This does not have to be done in Arabic. This could be said in Urdu, English, Farsi, Arabic, whatever language you want. It has to come from the heart though. The request to Allah has to come from the heart. And whoever gives water to a fasting person, Allah will quench him on the day of judgment from my fountain, from which he will not feel any thirst up until entering paradise. May Allah make this month of Ramadan a blessed one for all of us. May Allah give us the strength, the tawfiq, the ability to increase in our charities, in our ibadah, and ultimately, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Salaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.